Most people have fantasized about being able to travel into space. The majority of people who have become space enthusiasts have always questioned what life is like outside of space and what difficulties one may face attempting to live on another planet. Elon Musk's private flying company, SpaceX, appears to be the answer to many problems these days. Just last week, two senior Pentagon officials said they wished the Pentagon worked more like SpaceX, a 20-year-old aerospace startup that hopes to one day help colonize Mars. SpaceX was recently awarded a $102 million five-year contract by the U.S. Air Force to showcase technologies and capabilities for transporting military cargo and humanitarian goods around the world on a heavy rocket. The contract is for the Rocket Freight Program, a new project funded by the Air Force Laboratory that will look at the practicality of employing huge commercial rockets for international logistics for the Department of Defense. Musk, who recently believed the Russian government was attempting to assassinate him, gave his pitch for building a vehicle that represents the holy grail of space travel known as the SpaceX 425 project. On the 10th of February, standing beneath the towering profile of SpaceX's next-generation Starship rocket, after disclosing the threat he received to back up his theory, we'll discuss how Tesla's CEO is not only a visionary and a genius, but also an evolutionist who may be moving the interplanetary flying paradigm shift in this video. Look out for how SpaceX intends to alter the future. As infamous as this cargo machine is, and as long as SpaceX has been working on it, many people have been wondering what the massive machine is made of and what it's going to perform. The billionaire stepped out to provide a detailed description of the machine, including what it is, what it will do, and who will be joining the ship on its interplanetary quest. According to Musk, Starship is a roughly 400-foot-tall rocket that SpaceX has been working on to construct a vehicle that can transport freight and groups of people beyond Earth. According to Musk, the rocket is essential for establishing a human presence on other planetary bodies, such as the Moon and Mars. Musk went on to say that getting to Mars will be extremely hard, risky, but not impossible, and that it will be far from being some form of the escape hatch, disputing the concept that space travel is frivolous. Although public support for the development of Starship may appear to be unnecessary, Musk's vision for SpaceX's future depends on it. While the private firm raises billions from investors, the company has secured many taxpayer-funded contracts for the Starship, and it still needs federal approval to launch in earnest from its base on the Gulf Coast's southernmost tip. Musk feels that SpaceX's cost-effectiveness is the finest in history for any rocket development. We're talking about a rocket with twice the mass and thrust of a Saturn V rocket, and it is also planned to be entirely reusable at a development cost that is between 5% and 10% of the Saturn V, the rocket that launched the Apollo moon missions. It is also much preferable to develop a totally reusable vehicle from an environmental aspect, Musk continued, because rockets are normally thrown after each launch. Although some believe it is truly disturbing to build a rocket that would transport people and cargo to Mars, Musk claims that changing the world is something he holds dear to his heart and will continue to do year after year. Multiple companies, including SpaceX, accomplished a huge breakthrough in private human spaceflight this year, according to reports, but the thought of billionaires having fun in rockets drew widespread criticism. Musk opened his lecture by arguing that space exploration is necessary for providing security for life itself, having a fascinating future, and motivating kids about the future. Individuals complain daily, asking, "What about all the issues on Earth? Why doesn't Musk try to solve that rather than go to Mars?" Musk claims that this is one of the many complaints he occasionally hears, but few people realize that he agrees with the vast majority of people who demand that resources be committed to tackling Earth's issues. Musk believes that more than 99% of resources should be focused on solving problems on Mother Earth, but that maybe half of just 1% be spent on space exploration. During the lecture, the billionaire discussed how South Korea had strengthened its ties with SpaceX by signing a contract with the company to launch at least 5 military reconnaissance satellites on Falcon 9 rockets by the end of 2024. South Korea plans to launch its modest constellation of 5 new Earth observation satellites, known as the 425 Project, comprising four synthetic aperture radar satellites and one electro-optical infrared satellite. All five would aid in the near-constant observation of places of interest in North Korea, allowing for new observations every 2 hours at the very least. South Korea hopes to develop most or all aspects of those spacecraft locally, which will greatly benefit the country's aerospace industry. In recent years, developing local aerospace solutions has been a major industrial goal for the country. As a result, South Korea's first attempt at a domestic satellite constellation is unlikely to set any new records. The public goal is to construct spacecraft with a maximum resolution of 0.3 to 0.5 meters, 1 to 1.6 feet per pixel, which is comparable to most existing mid-sized Earth observation satellites. The U.S. military and espionage agency's secret capabilities, on the other hand, may give many times the resolving power. South Korea is a close ally of the United States, and likely, it benefits greatly from U.S. information sharing. However, it's unsurprising that a country with such a belligerent neighbor would wish to own and manage its fleet of spy satellites and be able to develop its spacecraft independently. South Korea has been constructing a fully domestic orbital launch capability in addition to working on the SpaceX spacecraft. In October 2021, the Korea Aerospace Research Institute, KRI, attempted to launch the first fully completed Korean satellite launch vehicle to KSLV-2, also known as NIRI, but it fell just short of orbit after its first and second stages performed as expected, but its third stage suffered from pressurization issues. NIRI is expected to fly again as soon as June 15, 2022. The South Korean rocket will be capable of launching up to 2.6 tons, 5,700 pounds, into low Earth orbit, LEO, and 1.5 tons, 3,300 pounds, into a slightly higher sun synchronous orbit once it is operational SSO. Instead, South Korea has planned to launch all five spacecraft using SpaceX rockets. SpaceX already has a strong connection with South Korea, has launched the Lockheed Martin-built Analysis, two military communications satellite, and is preparing to launch KRI's Korean Pathfinder Lunar Orbiter, KPLO, the country's first mission beyond Earth orbit, by August 2022. It's unclear if SpaceX would launch South Korea's 425 satellites in batches of two or four on dedicated Falcon 9s, as rideshare payloads alongside other paying customers, or as individual satellites on dedicated Falcon 9s. KPLO will be a Falcon 9 rideshare payload, indicating that South Korea is happy to take advantage of low-cost rideshare launches, though this may alter for military payloads. Regardless, SpaceX's commercial manifest, which presently includes about 7 to 5 publicly announced Falcon launches, will not be harmed by South Korea's recent deal. Environmental worries are at the forefront of Starship's future in Texas, but Musk is confident that SpaceX will be granted permission to proceed. According to Musk, SpaceX does not have a lot of insight into where things stand with the FAA, but they have obtained a general indication for clearance in March, which is positive for the firm and the ambitions they're willing to make a reality. Musk went on to say that the initiative will not be destructive to the environment, but rather will help push the ecosystem's boundaries further than they have ever been pushed before. Although SpaceX is examining its next steps if a more in-depth environmental evaluation is required, Musk has stated that doing so would cause the firm to be delayed for a long time, as plans for a launch have already been set in motion. Musk believes that the worst-case situation would be a 6 to 8 month delay while the Cape Launch Tower is constructed and the spaceship is launched from there. Although under that scenario, SpaceX would continue advanced R and D work in Texas. According to Musk, SpaceX does not have a lot of insight into where things stand with the FAA, but they have obtained a general indication for clearance in March, which is positive for the firm and the ambitions they're willing to make a reality. Musk went on to say that the initiative will not be destructive to the environment, but rather will help push the ecosystem's boundaries further than they have ever been pushed before. Although SpaceX is examining its next steps if a more in-depth environmental evaluation is required, Musk has stated that doing so would cause the firm to be delayed for a long time, as plans for a launch have already been set in motion. Musk believes that the worst-case situation would be a 6 to 8 month delay while the Cape launch tower is constructed and the spaceship is launched from there. Although under that scenario, SpaceX would continue advanced R and D work in Texas, which include testing out new designs and new versions of the rocket, it would utilize Cape Canaveral as the primary base of operations for Starship. What are your thoughts on the notion of developing a cargo ship that will travel to Mars? Leave a big thumbs up on this video if you found it interesting and exciting. And if you are new to our channel, subscribe and turn on your post notification to get updates. See you in the next video.